Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Let the name of the Lord be praised.
We are
going to open our Bibles in the same book of Luke.
Luke chapter 13.
Luke chapter 13.
Verse 6.
Reading from verse number 6.
I wish him my vangeli wango bachinga mbalela yonenga NLT. Ungari muyanda una yo apalanga NLT kari mupe mic.
Praise the Lord. Let us get it from the NLT version.
Luke chapter 6, chapter 13 verse 6.
It says, then Jesus told this story. A man planted a fig tree in his garden and came again and again to see if there was any fruit on it. But he was always disappointed.
Hey?
He was always disappointed.
Hey?
He was always disappointed.
I want that very same part.
He was always He was always disappointed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mune wa tsimu.
The owner of the field.
Chipinga chote mose achi ya tsimu.
Every time that he will go to the field.
Oba achi wana goyo mori wa muhuyo.
He will find that that fig tree.
Usina chitu.
Had no fruit.
Mose achi wana usina mchitu.
When he found that there was no fruit.
Bibili iri goyo muna oba achi disappointed.
The Bible says that man would always be disappointed.
Musina na bone riko dila na foundation.
When you and I are dealing with the foundation.
Una susune mudzimu ako.
There are things that God wants to see you and I having them. But God is getting disappointed because he finds you without those things. You might be speaking and saying, I have been disappointed a lot. I should have been at that level in life. It is not only you that is getting disappointed. Even God himself is getting disappointed. That if the foundation of my life is not right, the heavenly God does get disappointed about my life. When the foundation of my life is not delivered, what will be happening in my life, God gets disappointed about it. Now when this God comes back, he should no longer be disappointed in the That your days of disappointment are over. Your days of disappointment are over. This foundation has to know that there should be fruits that get back on me. There should be accomplishment when it comes to me. That spirit of disappointment, it has to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Refuse to live a life of being disappointed. Refuse to be disappointed by people. Refuse to be disappointed at work. Refuse to be disappointed in your dream. In the name of Jesus Christ. What is happening in your business? It makes you to feel disappointed in your spirit. But I want to say this in the name of Jesus. I refuse to live a life of gossip. I refuse to live a life of gossip. And even God should not be disappointed. God should not be disappointed by me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Enemy is the one to be disappointed. God doesn't have to be disappointed with what is happening in my life. Another day I have to celebrate all the works that God has done for me. Amazing in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Ask your friend who is seated next to you the things that are happening to you.
Don't they make you not to be disappointed? Don't they make you to feel ashamed?
Hey?
Hello? After this service, you and I have to see shame at a distance. Even what is happening to our children with is shameful, it has to be seen at a distance. Refuse to live a life of being shamed. Refuse to live in a family that is shamed. Refuse to live with parents that have been shamed. That which makes your parents to look as if they are ashamed. Let it leave the whole family in the name of Jesus Christ. Refuse to be put to shame in the name of Jesus Christ. I am saying refuse to be put to shame in the name of Jesus Christ. After this prayer, somebody will be able to rise up and stand. Because they will no longer be having shame in the name of Jesus Christ. What is happening in somebody's life? It is leaving them without good health. It makes them to lack words to speak. It leaves them being ashamed even in the community. But there is a God in the name of Jesus Christ who has to take away the shame that I have. Who has to take away the shame from the family. He has to take away the shame from my children. In the name of Jesus
Hallelujah.
Christ, praise the Lord. Last week on a Sunday, as we were praying here, Prophet spoke another message. She said, fight against the spirit of death. She said, fight against the spirit of death. That testimony that I shared with you here, the parents of the children when they were here didn't it bring the salvation to the child? I am asking, didn't it bring the salvation of that child? There is no word that comes out here and doesn't work. There is no word that gets spoken here and doesn't work. As we were praying here on a Sunday, can I please receive my phone? We want to pray not long. There are people that have been put to shame in life. Because what is happening to you, it puts you to shame.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. God was coming year after year, thinking that he will find your situation changed. And he finds your situation not changed at all. But 2019, that situation has changed. That situation has changed. I refuse to live a life of shame that is filled with shame. I want to show you something that happened on Sunday here. As we were praying right here, while we were here praying, there was a child that God was saving. The mother was getting deliverance right here. While we were busy praying, that child was involved in a very fatal accident.
Majou
Hill. The car flied and fell into the ditch. But the God that we serve is an amazing God. That child came out without even a scratch in the body. But the car was beyond. The car was beyond. Just look at your screen.
It happened
while we were here and praying. Look at your screen next to you. And look at the wonders of God. Don't undermine prayer. Don't undermine prayer. The prophet said you shall live. Even your children shall live. Speaking on a Sunday. And prophet was speaking on a Sunday. And said that family of yours, that foundation of your family. What is it that happened in a particular year? And we ask what happens in a particular year. That car. Look at it. Look at your screens. Look at your screens. And look at what prayer does. It is the prayer. That is the airbags that came out. Those are the airbags that came out. People that know Majou here, and you will look at the ditch that goes down that side. That car went down there, and the mother was praying and getting delivered here, while we were rebuking the spirit of death. And that child received the miracle of life. The child received the miracle of life. I speak up in the name of Jesus Christ. Refuse to be shamed. Refuse to be put to shame. Refuse the spirit of disappointment. Refuse to live a life of disappointment. I refuse to live a life of shame. I refuse to live a life of shame. I refuse to have children that are ashamed. I refuse to live a life of shame. I refuse in the name of Jesus. I refuse in the name of Jesus. I have been disappointed. It is enough. I have been disappointed. It is enough.
Not in 2019.
Not in 2019. 2019.
2019.
Are you getting this word? And this very same prayer, there is somebody who is here. Right now when we are here, Satan is planning to put you to shame. But this prayer that we are going to pray can save you. Satan is planning to shame you. He doesn't want to put you to shame in your house only. I see him planning things in your workplace so that you can be disappointed. That which you are expecting, you should not receive. I destroy this spirit in the name of Jesus. Those who are planning it should be the ones to be put to shame. Those who are planning it are the ones to be put to shame. I see them organizing papers that somebody is supposed to be disappointed. In their mind, they are expecting to see great things. But the enemy is standing in the corner, and he wants to disappoint you. This afternoon, I am saying the Lord is reversing, so that you should no longer be put to shame. God is reversing, so that you should no longer be put to shame. Refuse to be disappointed. Refuse to be disappointed. Am I speaking to somebody? Am I speaking to somebody here? While we are here, praying right here, I have an interview that I conducted. God has something that He's saying. The answer that was coming, it was not good at all. But God of this house, through the prayer that we are going to pray, the employer will change his mind. The employer is going to change his mind. And God is going to reveal it. When you have already received that post, there will be somebody that will whisper to you, that will come and say to you, it was not you that was supposed to be seated here. This chair had its owner. But I hear the God of this house speaking. You have been disappointed, it is enough. God said, I am going to do it in another way in the name of Jesus. Where you are coming from, it's filled with disappointment. It is filled with disappointment. Things don't come the way that you are expecting them to come. But God is speaking in the name of Jesus Christ. It will be compelled to come in a way that you want it to come. It will be forced. Let us all stand upon our feet. You and I, things will be forced. The things of our children are going to be forced. Speak and say it is going to be forced. Speak up and say it is going to be forced. In the name of Jesus Christ, with our hands raised up, we are going to pick up a song. And we are all going for prayer. That shame that we have been made to wear, God wants to remove it. The Bible says the owner of the field was disappointed. Because when he came, he found nothing.
Until
living a life that doesn't bear fruits, it can make you to be disappointed. And it doesn't disappoint you alone, it also disappoints your Creator. Now God wants to be proud through the good things that he would have done to people's lives. The one who is refusing it to come to pass, I speak to him in the name of Jesus. The one who refuses it to come to pass, I speak with him in the name of Jesus. That is going to be forced by the Spirit of God. It is going to be forced. It is going to be forced. What is it that should not happen? She will no longer live a life of disappointment. In her workplace, in her businesses, in her family, in her children, in her health, in the name of Jesus.
Tendo. All of them are going to work in the name of Jesus Christ. Tendo. Murilo wa Yesu ko murichezeni mimoya yoshoneza ya ushuma husina chine mtu akana ndikaringa dzina la Yesu Kristo murichezeni twa note nga dzina la Yesu noba nikotodani noba nikotodani noba nikotodani
what is it that you want
kamirenzeni kabokoro mtu Ngazina la Yesu Kristo. Tuwani no hote. Kariba ndile murena Yesu Kristo. Nerimeni.
What are you saying?
Nerimeni.
What are you saying?
Ndikorimi mwaya yote yofaro uchulo hawe.
Spirits that are binding here lies.
Ndikoni kwa sato ngazina la mandala mrena Jesu.
I'm bruising your head in the name of
no
Jesus.
No fara unarushaka lwa hawe.
You are possessing the whole
family. Ndikoni kwa sato ngazina la Yesu Kristo.
I bruise your head in the name of Jesus. Leave this child.
Lichazani wana huu.
Leave this child.
Nerimini.
What are you saying?
Hey. Ndikoringa dzina la Yesu Kristo.
I'm saying in the name of
Jesus. Marwadze.
Spirit of sickness.
Ndikorimi mwaya ya marwadze.
Spirit of sickness.
Ndi akwashekanya ka dzina la Yesu.
I destroy you in the name of Jesus.
Leave her.
Murichadze. Leave her.
Ni mwaya ya marwadze.
You spirit of sickness.
Ka dzina la manda la murena Yesu Kristo.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Muliro miyamketwa.
Here come the fire of Jesus.
Mubopololi.
Deliver him.
Mudzimu achilawo.
The living God.
Nga Yesu Kristo.
In Jesus Christ.
Kari mutakose. Kadengene.
I experience flu and sometimes my head will
be.
Also have headache when you want to study your books.
Flu ini farali yoni farazino ni chibala buku kana ni yoto dazino.
Exam ichi thoma ndafandi chibva kuvala buku. Ndafara thanga ichirema ndatobva apo risina mando vhara.
Chipinga chine navano ko yongwala examination.
By the time when you're going to write your examination.
Ni thoma vaisana.
You will become sick.
Moya wa marwadzi.
That is the spirit of sicknesses.
Moya wa marwadzi.
The spirit of sickness.
Moya wa marwadzi.
The spirit of sickness.
Moya wa marwadzi.
The spirit of sickness.
Ndikorupa zvino.
I'm saying from right now.
Achongwala mlingo.
When she goes for the
exam. Anichate yo mushegedza kha dzina la Yesu.
Tuwari. Go.
Chibira.
Go.
Helen.
Go to hell.
Moya ya Satan.
The spirit of Satan.
Murichedze.
Leave her.
Murichedze.
Leave her.
Murichedze.
Leave her.
Nga dzina la Yesu.
In the name of Jesus.
Karise phanda na luimbo.
Emudimu alite hararuna.
Emudimu
alite hararuna.